promotion does not come from the east, it doesn't come from the west. It comes straight from my God. When God promotes you, nobody can stop it. When God lifts you up, nobody can bring you down. When God says it is your time, it is your time. Today is the turning point. Today is the turning point. To your breakthrough. To your breakthrough. To your breakthrough. In the name of Jesus. Every power that wants to swallow your pain in this year, I decree in the name of Jesus, the blood of Jesus will swallow them. The blood of Jesus will consume them. In the name of Jesus. Every generational curse that is tying you down this morning, I reverse it. I say I reverse it. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus.
Welcome tonight in the name of Jesus. I want you to begin to appreciate the Lord, because the Lord has been good. His mercies have actually shown in our lives. We bless his name. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Delay is over in your life. You will not experience delay again in the name of Jesus. Overcoming the storm of life. Overcoming the storm of life. As long as we are in this world, we come across challenges. You come across challenges. But how do you overcome these challenges? How do we overcome these challenges? One thing that is good we should know is what actually brings problem into our lives, or causes of problem in our life. I will show you about three sources of problems in our life, and I will, through the scripture, show you how we can overcome some of these problems. Number one source of problem is other people. There may be people we are working with, there may be people we are relating with, they may even be our parents, the vehicle God used to bring us into this world, they may be our grandparents. They may be friends. There are great examples in the scriptures. If you remember the story of Joseph, Joseph's problem started from his brothers, his blood brothers. They were the one who conspired against him, and they were the one who, you know, took him, threw him into the pit. From the pit, they sold him into slavery, and he became a slave in Egypt. And from there, the journey of his life continued. So his blood brothers were people that caused his problem. Just as Jesus Christ said, your greatest enemies are members of your household. In the case of David, if you remember when he was on the throne, his problem started from his son. Remember the story of Absalom. Absalom was his son who conspired against him and threw me off the throne and sat on the throne before God, dethroned Absalom. That's his own blood, his son, his own biological son. They may be our relatives. You remember also that David had problem with King Saul. David was just a lad when you think of King Saul, but King Saul wanted to kill David because he saw the grace of God upon his life. I mean, these are just examples to show that other people can be sources or source of our problem. If you look at Lamentation chapter 5, let's see this example. Lamentation chapter 5, verse 7. The Bible says, our fathers have sinned and are not, and we are born their iniquities. It was their father that sinned, but they were the one that beared or bore the result of the iniquity. And what were the result of the iniquity? Servants have ruled over us, servant begin to rule over them. So they were worse than servants. They were worse than servants. And there's nobody to deliver them. What he is saying here is that the sin of the father was imputed, or the sins of the father were imputed upon the children. You agree with me that our parents who brought us into this world, they were very important in our life. Important, they can affect our destiny positively and negatively. The devil can really deal with us as a result of the sins of our parents. They are the vehicle God have used to bring us into this world. But you know that many of them prepare for us bed of thorns. It's not bed of roses, but beds of problems, beds of affliction, beds of thorns. That was what Jeremiah was complaining of, that it was their father that committed sin. But the children were the ones that are bearing the iniquities. Do you know your parents? Do you know your grandparents? I've seen people, I've had opportunity of counseling people, that when they were young and they were growing up in their lives, they happened to stay with one of their grandparents, particularly their grandmother. Some of them have come across, they stay with their grandmother. And because their grandmother were ungodly, they didn't know God. They were priests of the devil. The innocent children that were staying with them, grandchildren, they dedicated them to their idol. They dedicated them to the gods they were serving. I remember one vividly that became the wife of the prince of the coast. And as this young lady began to grow up, it was on her that she must not be physically married. And they gave her what will happen to her. And along the line, she knew the law, she got married, but she didn't break the covenant the grandmother made with the prince of the coast. And when it was exactly 1 year when this sister got married, the repercussion of the marriage came, the repercussion of the covenant came, and she began to have problems in life. We want to thank God for Jesus. Jesus delivered her because she had made a new covenant with Jesus. When the covenant the grandmother made was broken, the covenant she made with Jesus can begin to supersede over her life, and she was delivered. Which problem are you going through today? Which problem are you going? Are you actually doing what they call spiritual mapping about your parents? Because some of the problems, some of the yokes we are carrying actually originated from our family line. Because the Bible says in the book of Exodus, from verse 3 to 5, you must not serve any other God except me. Because God is going to require the iniquities of the father upon the children to the third and fourth generation of those that hate me. Do you know your parents? Do you know your grandparents? Do you know what they have done? Do you know what they have done? Do you know whether you have been covenanted unto an idol? Have you read Judges chapter 6 before? The story of Gideon. In Judges chapter 6, if you read the story very well, Gideon was born, came forth so as to deliver the children of Israel out of the hands of the Midianites. But if you see that story, Gideon was hiding from the Midianites. You know, he was sent by God to deliver Israel for the hands of the Midianites. But the enemy, he was supposed to deliver Israel from their hand, he was hiding from them. Because of what? If you read that Judges chapter 6, as from around verse 23 down, the angel of God told him, go to your father's house. There's something you need to destroy. There's an altar of Baal in your father's house. Go and destroy it. Gideon wasn't the one who built the altar. It was his father who built the altar. But the altar became an impediment to Gideon, became a yoke unto Gideon. Gideon could not manifest in his destiny because of the altar of Baal in his father's house, overcoming the storm of life. Is there an altar in your father's house that is speaking against you? Is there an altar in your father's house speaking against you? The truth about it, altars speak. Altars have a voice. When you want to begin to rise, and it's an altar of the devil, that your name has been inscribed, your destiny has been inscribed, the altar begins to speak. It was that altar that was speaking against Gideon. The angel of God saw Gideon and said, go in your might. The angel saw might in him. The angel saw grace in him. The angel saw power in him. The angel saw that he was a man that was destined to be a deliverer. But the altar in his father's house tied him down, prevented him from being what he was sent to be. And the angel said, go destroy the altar in your father's house. I say unto you also today, is there an altar in your father's house that is speaking against you, that is tying your destiny down? Go forth and destroy the altar. You may not be able to go physically to destroy the altar as Gideon did, but you can destroy the altar on your name. You can destroy the altar with your prayer and fasting. You can decree a thing and it shall be established. You can uproot that altar to its foundation on your name. Can you go on to do that? If you know there's an altar in your father's house working against your destiny. That's what happened in Gideon's life. But when Gideon destroyed the altar, if you go to chapter 7 of Judges, and Gideon blew the trumpet of war, 30,000 people ran unto Gideon. Those 30,000 were there before. Those destiny helpers were there before. But the altar of Baal in his father's house closed the door, closed the gate against those destiny helpers. You are not finding help. Can there be an altar in your father's house driving away help from you? Today, by the name of Jesus, I silence that altar. I root that altar out. I set that altar ablaze in the name of Jesus. I stop the work of that altar in your life in the name of Jesus. I terminate the operation of that altar in your life in the name of Jesus. As Gideon destroyed the altar, he blew the trumpet and 30,000 people came forth. People came forth. Help came for Gideon. Enough help came that God said, no, these ones are too many. Go and reduce them. And you know, there is help for you. I decree there is help. Are you going through storm in life? Are those storm in life coming from other people? Are they coming from other people? If you look at Matthew chapter 13, verse 25, the Bible says about the parable. I'm sure you know the parable very well. The key thing I want us to know about the parable is that while men slept, his enemy came and sowed tares among the wheat and went his way. There was a man that prepared his ground and planted good seed. I'm sure you have planted good seed in your life. You are expecting harvest. But instead of harvest, you find tares in your harvest. The Bible said, it was not the man who put the tar. It was the devil that came to put the tar. But why? Because men were sleeping. Men were sleeping. Men were sleeping. So what are the challenges we are going through today? What are the challenges? Are they caused by other people? Are they caused because of your foundational, your root, your foundation, your origin, the family you come from? Are they there because of your parents, your grandparents, the God they served, the idol they served? Can this be the reason? You know what I want you to do today? I want you to confess the lordship of Jesus Christ over your life right now. I want you to commit that thing unto the Lord Jesus right now. That area of talent you are finding in your life. You know, Gideon, the angel of God came to him and the angel told him what to do. I am telling you exactly what you should do to come out of that challenge. Confess the lordship of Jesus over your life. And after you have done that, now begin to take authority over the spirit that are responsible for that challenge in your life. If their spirit from your father's house, their spirit from your grandmother, grandfather's house, their spirit, their foundational spirit, their generational spirit, their familiar spirit of your family, begin to take authority over them. Say, I take authority over you. You spirit that is responsible to the delay in my life, to the disappointment in my life, to this storm of life in my life, in the name of Jesus, I take authority over you. I take authority over you. I subdue you. I paralyze you. In the name of Jesus, now command that spirit out of your life. In the name of Jesus, command it out of your life. But tell it, that spirit, as he's going, everything concerning you that he has swallowed up, begin to vomit it. Vomit my life, vomit my children, vomit my husband, vomit my health. In the name of Jesus, storm of life. What I've just told you is that storm of life may come as a result of the sins of other people. May come as a result of the sins of other people. Number two, another source where challenges come in life is the devil. Look at the book of John chapter 10. St. John chapter 10. St. John chapter 10. Look at verse 10. The thief cometh not but to steal and to kill and to destroy. That's the source, another source of challenge in our life. The thief. Who is the thief? The thief is the devil. And you see what he has come to do? He's come to steal. He can steal your joy. He can steal your health. He can steal your finances. He can steal whatever you allow him to steal in your life. He can steal your home. He can steal your marriage. He can steal your husband. He can steal your wife. He can steal your children. Even your academics, he can steal. Your business, he can steal. I'm sure you have heard story, either you have heard, you have read. Children that are stolen from the womb. The woman will just wake up and find that the pregnancy was no longer there, or is no longer there. The baby is no longer there. The tummy becomes flat. I'm sure you have heard that. I have heard that. I have seen that severally. He's able to steal. It's not only stealing. He can kill. He kills. You allow him to kill. He will kill. He kills physically. He kills spiritually. He kills financially. He kills academically. He kills maritally. Anything you allow him to steal, he will steal it. Anything, he will steal it. And he can kill. That's what the devil does. That's what the devil does. Because in the book of 1 Peter chapter 5 verse 8, the Bible says, he's like a roaring lion. He's like a roaring lion, seeking whom he wants to devour. Seeking whom, devour means destruction. Seeking whom he wants to destroy. The devil. And there are many ways people play into the devil's hand. The devil plays into, people play into the devil's hand. You see, when you refuse to serve God, in the spiritual level, there are two spirit worlds. The spirit of God, the kingdom of God, and the kingdom of the devil. I want to tell you today, you either belong to the kingdom of God spiritually, or you belong to the kingdom of the devil. There's no middle way. You cannot stay in the middle. You have to belong to one of them. You don't belong to God, you belong to the devil. You don't belong to God, then you belong to the devil. You don't believe in God, then you are with the devil. You are with the devil. That is the problem. That is the problem. You see, in the book of Revelation chapter 12 verse 9, and the great dragon was cast out. Look at his name. He's the old serpent. Revelation 12 verse 9 is the devil. He's called Satan. Which deceived the whole world. Is the dragon, is the serpent, is the devil, is Satan. He has so many forms and so many characteristics. And one of his characteristics is to kill, to destroy, and to steal. So the devil, if you play into the hands of the devil, you don't belong to God, you belong to the devil. And he tosses you up and down. He deals with you the way he wants. He deals with you the way he wants. He deals with you the way he wants. Do you belong to Jesus? Is Jesus your Lord? All these experiences you are seeing in your life, do you believe in belong to Jesus? You don't belong to Jesus, you belong to the devil. You remember the story of Job in Job chapter 1 verse 7. The devil goes to and fro. And you know what he did to Job? He destroyed all his children, destroyed all his property, and afflicted him with disease. That's what the devil does. But because Job believed in the Lord, he said, I know that my Redeemer liveth. God stopped the hands of the devil, and God restored everything that Job had. God restored everything. Do you see the hand of the devil in your life? And you want a restoration. What I want you to do again is to believe in Jesus. Confess the lordship of Jesus over your life. It's because Job stood his ground in the Lord. He said, I know that my Redeemer liveth. God came. God arose and delivered Job. And the captivity of Job was restored. And everything he lost were given back to him. I want you to believe in the Lord. Confess the lordship of Jesus. And after you have done that, now begin to say, Father, in the name of Jesus, every power of the enemy, every power from the pit of hell tormenting my life, in the name of Jesus, I command the fire of the Lord to begin to consume you now. I raise the name of Jesus against you. I command you to remove your hand from my head, from my family, from my marriage, from my children, from my finances, in the name of Jesus. I dismantle your power over my life in the name of Jesus. Finally, God also can bring challenges to your life. If you look at Exodus chapter 20, that's the last scripture we want to read briefly. Exodus chapter 20, look at verse 5. Exodus 20 verse 5. Look at what the Bible says. Thou shalt not bow thyself to them, nor serve them. For I, the Lord thy God, am a jealous God, visiting the iniquity of the fathers upon the children to the third and fourth generation of them that hate me. You must serve God and God alone. This is what he says. He says he's a jealous God. You serve any other God, you're on your own. God is jealous. He's jealous. And that is why you must serve God alone. If you don't serve God, you are serving the devil. And God says he's going to visit the iniquity, even of your father. Your own iniquity is going to punish you for it. And if your fathers have served idol, served any other God, he's going to visit that iniquity also on you. Are you serving God today? Do you believe in the Lord today? Do you believe in Jesus as the Lord and the Savior of the world? I want you today to confess the lordship of Jesus Christ over your life. Look at the challenges, the storm of life you are going through. The only solution to it is Jesus. Job went through the storms of life, but he held on to God, and God delivered him. And God restored his captivity. God gave him everything he has lost in multiple. The same thing can happen to you. Joseph went through the storm of life. Took conspiracy from his brothers. But you remember, the destiny of Joseph was fulfilled. Mordecai went to, challenges. Gallo was made so that he could be hanged. But because he believed in the Lord fought for him. The children of Israel went through a lot of challenges in Susan. But because they held unto their God, they fasted, they prayed, they believed in the Lord. And God delivered them. The same God can deliver you today from these storms of life. If only you believe on the Lord Jesus Christ and commit all these anxieties unto him, he will meet your need. So I want you to just cry unto the Lord today. Cry unto the Lord and commit your life unto the Lord. Ask Jesus to be your Lord and your Savior. And after you have done that, begin to raise all those prayer points I've given you. Begin to commit all these challenges into the Lord. And the Lord is going to take care of them as I pray for you tonight. Lord, as many as have committed their lives unto you, I pray, Father, that in the name of Jesus, you will take care of all the anxieties, all the challenges in their life, in the name of Jesus. And Father, I decree that as you restore the captivity of Job, you will restore their captivity. You will change their money into victory, in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. You will change their ashes into beauty, in the name of Jesus. You will decorate them and put a fresh oil upon their lives, in the name of Jesus. Your life is turned into a life of testimony, in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. I rebuke every devourer in your life, in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. We give you all the glory, Lord. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Amen. I assure you, if you have taken those steps, there will be testimony, in the name of Jesus. As I invite you all again to our deliverance school, every Wednesday, 5 p.m. at Better Bible Church, number 1 Victory Avenue, off Books Road, in Graceland. God bless you. In Jesus' name. Amen.
We believe you've been richly blessed through this teaching by God's servant, Pastor J.A. Onolapo. And as you apply these kingdom principles, you will be liberated from every satanic power that has tied down your destiny. For he that Jesus has set free is free indeed. Worship with us every Sunday at 7 a.m. first service and 9:30 a.m. second service. Come and experience the power that destroys every satanic yoke in our deliverance school every Wednesday at 5 p.m. And meet with God who answers prayer in our solution hour every Thursday at 5 p.m. Have a date with destiny in our anointing service every first Sunday of the month at 9 a.m. And every first Thursday of the month is our Holy Communion and Breaking of Curses service at 5 p.m. Our Overcomers Day comes up every first day of the month at 6 a.m. at Bethel Bible Church, number 1 Victory Avenue, Graceland, Zaria, Nigeria. For maximum academic performance and excellence, spiritual and good moral training, enroll your child or ward today at Bethel Schools. Application forms are available in daycare, nursery, primary and secondary session at Bethel Schools, number 1 Victory Avenue, Graceland, Zaria, Nigeria. Are you a minister, church leader, church worker, or you are aspiring to be one? Enroll in Bethel Global Bible College for diploma and higher diploma in ministerial studies. We train to attain. God bless you.